Hi everyone, Monisha here. In this video, I will be completing exercise 4.1 of chapter determinants. I hope this video will be interesting for you. Please concentrate on this chapter because determinants is very important for your board exam. Let us start the session. So let us start exercise 4.1. The first question is evaluate the determinants. Okay, so here the first question is 2, 4, minus 5 and minus 1. So here we have to evaluate the determinant. So how we have to evaluate the determinant? We have to multiply the diagonal elements. Okay, we have to find the product of diagonal elements and we have to subtract it. Okay, so the product element is 2 into minus 1. So 2 into minus 1, and next will be the subtraction of the product of the diagonal elements. So diagonal element is 2 into minus 1, then subtraction means minus 4 into minus 5. Okay, so 2 into minus 1 is minus 2, here minus is there, minus into minus is plus, 4 5s are 20. So what is 20 minus 2? 20 minus 2 is 18. So this is the method of finding out the determinant. Okay, so first we have to multiply the diagonal element, that is 2 into minus 1. Next we have to subtract it, okay, minus 4 into minus 5. 2 into minus 1 is minus 2, minus and minus will be plus, 4 into 5 is 20. 20 minus 2 is 18. Okay, so let us move on to the second question. So question 2, again in question 2 we have to evaluate the determinants. Okay, so write down the same thing, evaluate the determinants. Okay, so here again the first question, the first sub question is cos theta minus sin theta and sin theta and cos theta. Okay, this is the question, cos theta minus sin theta, sin theta and cos theta. Here we have to find out the determinant. First what we have to do, multiply the elements, diagonal elements, that is cos theta into cos theta. Next we have to subtract, therefore minus. Next sin theta into minus sin theta. Okay, so either you can multiply like this or like this. Okay, cos theta into cos theta minus sin theta into minus sin theta. So cos theta into cos theta is cos square theta, minus into minus is plus, sin theta into sin theta is sin square theta. In trigonometric identities, there is a formula in trigonometric identity. So trigonometric identity, cos square theta plus sin square theta is always 1. So this is the trigonometric identity. Okay, because cos square theta plus sin square theta is always equal to 1. So this is a formula in trigonometry. So according to that formula, we are deriving it as cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. Okay, so moving on to the second sub question of question number 2. The second one is x square minus x plus 1, x minus 1, x plus 1 and x plus 1. Okay, so this is the determinant given, x square minus x plus 1, x minus 1, x plus 1 and x plus 1. Again we have to find out the determinant. Here multiplication of the diagonal elements, that is x square minus x plus 1, we have to multiply it with x plus 1. Okay, so next minus, minus x plus 1 into x minus 1. Okay, product of the diagonal elements. So this with this and this with this, we have to multiply it. Okay, so here x into, so each and every element should be multiplied with the either element. So x into x square minus x plus 1. So in here first term I have taken x into the whole term, remaining is plus 1 here, plus 1 into the whole term, x square minus x plus 1. Okay, minus is there, just write it down, minus. So algebraic identities, if you remember, in algebraic identities there is a formula, that is a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square, right? Here instead of a plus b, here the term is x plus 1 into x minus 1. So x plus 1 into x minus 1 is x square minus 1 square. Okay, a square minus b square, a square minus b square is a plus b a minus b. Okay, so next x into x square is x cube minus x into x is x square. Here plus is there, so write down plus. X into 1 is x itself. Okay, so I have multiplied from x, I have multiplied the whole term here. X into x square, x cube. X into x is x square and x into 1 is x. Next, from plus 1, I have to multiply everything. So plus 1 into all the term will be same. So x square minus x plus 1. Okay, now I have to take these terms outside of this bracket. So minus into here, nothing means there will be a plus. So minus into plus is always minus. Minus x square. Minus and minus is plus. So minus 1 square will be always 1. Okay. So now x cube is there. X cube write down as it is. X square and x square. So both are x square. Write it down near to that. Minus x square minus x square. And here one more x square is there. So plus x square. Okay. So next plus x and minus x. Plus x minus x is there. Next plus 1 and plus 1 is there. Okay, don't get confused. You have to just write down the terms which have the same power. First is x cube and no other element has x cube here. Next is x square. Minus x square plus x square and minus x square. Okay, next is x and x. Next is 1 and 1. Okay, so here what happens? This minus x square plus x square get cancels. Plus x and minus x get cancels. The remaining will be here x cube minus x square plus 1 and plus 1 is plus 2. Okay. So the answer is x cube minus x square plus 2. Okay, I hope you understood this. So moving on to the third question. So here a matrix is given. A matrix is 1, 2, 4, 2, where we have to find out LHS is equal to RHS. That is, determinant 2A is equal to 4 determinant A. This we have to prove. Okay, so first we have to find out this 2A. So see here, we have to prove determinant 2A into 4 into determinant A. Okay, so first I will be taking LHS. LHS is determinant 2A. Here first we have to take, in order to take the determinant, first we have to multiply 2A. Here it is given only A. Okay, so first what we have to do, we have to find out 2A. So 2A is 2 into matrix A, that is 1, 2 and 4, 2. So first we have to multiply each and every element in the matrix with 2. Okay, so 2A will become 2 ones are 2. 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8 and 2 2s are 4. So this is the matrix 2A. So next what we have to find, we have to find determinant 2A. Okay. So determinant 2A means we have to just replace this square bracket into vertical straight line. Okay. Vertical line. So 2, 4, 8 and 4. So this is determinant. So how we have to find the determinant? We have to multiply the product diagonal. And then to subtract. So 2 4s are. So 2 into 4 minus 8 into 4. So what is 2 into 4? 2 into 4 is 8. 8 4s are 32. So 32 minus 8 is minus 24. So LHS will become minus 24. Okay. Let this be equation number 1. So this is LHS. Next we have to move on to RHS. Okay. So RHS is 4 into determinant A. So we have found out determinant 2A but not determinant A. In order to find this, we have to first calculate determinant A. Here A is 1, 2, 4, 2. So matrix we have to change into a determinant form by writing vertical lines 1, 2, 4, 2. Next to find the determinant of A, we have to multiply the diagonal terms. That is 1 into 2 minus 4 into 2. Okay. So 1 2s are 2, 4 2s are 8. So this is determinant A will be minus 6. So determinant A is minus 6. Next what we have to find out? 4 into determinant A. Okay. So 4 into what is determinant A? Minus 6. 4 6 are 24. So 4 into minus 6 is minus 24. Okay. So this is 4 into determinant A. So this is equation 2. So from equation 1 and 2, what happens? LHS is equal to RHS. That is 2A determinant is equal to 4 into determinant A. I hope you understood this. Moving on to the fourth question. It is just as that of the previous question, but here 3 into 3 matrix has been given. Here we need to prove determinant 3A is equal to 27 into determinant A. Okay. So here first we have to take LHS into RHS. So first I will be taking LHS in this part, that is determinant 3A. So before doing determinant 3A, here only matrix A has been given. We don't know what is 3A. First we have to do this problem, that is 3A we have to do. We have to simplify this. Okay. So 3A is equal to 3 into matrix A, that is 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2 and 0, 0, 4. Okay. So when we multiply it, we have to multiply each and every element in the matrix by 3. So 3 into 1 is 3, 3 into 0, 0, 3 into 1, 3, 0, 3, 3 2s are 6, 0, 0, 3 4s are 12. Okay. So this is 3A matrix. So next what we have to do? We have to do the determinant of it. So 3A determinant. Okay. So before doing determinant, we can take any row or any column, but it will be wise enough if we take a row or column which has maximum number of zeros. So here maximum number of zeros is in first column or third row. So I'll be taking first column to find out the determinant part of it. So how we have to take the determinant? So here I am taking first row. So each and every element I'll be taking in that. In first thing, I'll be taking 3 first. Okay. So if you are taking 3, the row corresponding to that 3 and the column corresponding to that 3 will deletes. Okay. So these two lines will deletes. If you are taking this 3 means these two lines goes. That is the row and the column. The remaining will be 3, 6, 0, 12. So that is the thing we have to write. Okay. Determinant 3, 6, 0, 12. Okay. So first one I have taken. So next 0 I have to take. Whenever you are taking the middle term, you have to insert a minus symbol here. Okay, minus 0. So if I take 0, then this row, the row which is corresponding to this 0 and the column which is corresponding to the 0 will deletes. Okay, so this column and this row will goes because we have taken the middle term 0. So if this row deletes, then the remaining will be 0, 3, 0, 12. That you have to write. 0, 3, 0, 12. Okay, so next. In first column, two elements we have taken, the last one is 0. So that is plus 0. So when I take a plus 0, so this row and this column deletes. Okay, remaining will be 0, 3, 3, 6. So why we have to take the row or column which has maximum number of zeros means those things will cancels. Because any number multiplied by 0 will be 0 itself. So these two terms cancels, only this will be remaining. Okay. So what we have to do, we have to multiply the diagonal elements and we have to subtract it. So 3 into, so here 12 3s are 36 minus 6 into 0 is 0 itself. Here it is 0 into anything. So 0 into anything is 0 plus 0 plus 0 into anything is 0 itself. This both terms will become 0. The remaining will be 3 into 36. So 3 into 36 is equal to 18, 1 carry, 3 is a 9 and 10. That is 108. That is 3A determinant is 108. Okay. So let this be equation 1. We have found out the LHS part of it. Now we have to take RHS. Okay. So here RHS is 27 determinant A. So here matrix A has been given. We have to first find out determinant of A. Okay. So determinant of A is equal to 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 2 and 0, 0, 4. Just as this determinant section, we have to find it out. Okay. So we have to find it out the determinant part. So here, again, I will be taking this column because this column has maximum number of zeros. Okay. So first I will be taking 1. If I take 1, then this row and this column will get cancels. Remaining will be 1, 2, 0 and 4. Okay. So next is second one, that is 0. If we are taking middle term, we have to insert a minus symbol. So next, if we take 0 here, this row and this column deletes. The remaining will be 0, 1, 0, 4. Okay. Next is last, plus 0. So if we take 0, this row and this column deletes. Remaining will be 0, 1, 1, 2. Okay. So here, 1 into 4 ones are 4. Minus 2 into 0 is 0. Okay. Here since 0 is there, these all things will, terms will cancel. So remaining the determinant of A. So the determinant of A is 4 minus 0. 4 minus 0 is 4 itself. So it will be 4. But here we have to find out 27 determinant A. So 27 into determinant A is 4. So 27 into 4. So 4 7s are 28, 2 carry, 4 2s are 8, plus 2 is 10. That is 108. So from 1 and 2, LHS is equal to RHS. Therefore, 3A determinant is equal to 27A determinant. Okay, I hope you understood this problem. Moving on to the fifth question. So in fifth question, we have to find out only the determinants. So before finding the determinants, what we have to consider? We have to consider the row or column which has maximum number of zeros. Okay, and one thing you have to keep it in mind. So the middle term, here the middle term is minus 1. So here the middle term is 0, here the middle term is minus 5, and here the middle term is minus 1. If these middle terms comes in your calculation, only at that time you have to take minus 1. Okay, you have to take minus there. So rest of the things you have to take plus itself. Okay, that thing you have to keep in mind. I am taking this row because maximum number of zeros are there in second row. Okay, so here first 0. So if I take 0 here, I have to delete this row and this column. So what is remaining? So if this row and this column is deleted, what is remaining here? That is minus 1, minus 2, minus 5 and 0. So this will be remaining. Okay. So here the middle term is 0, but this middle term should not be encased with minus 1. So here we have to take a plus 0 itself. Why? Because the middle term has to be the outer side of the matrix. Either it should be minus 1, 0, minus 5 and minus 1. Okay, so here 0 is there. If I take 0, this column and this row will cancel. The remaining will be all the edge terms. That is 3, minus 2, 3 and 0. Last is minus 1. We know that minus 1 is the middle term of the end terms. Okay, end row or end column. So before writing minus 1, we have to put one more minus here. So minus of minus 1. Okay, into if I take this minus 1, this column and this row get cancels. Remaining will be, so this row, okay, this row and this column will get cancelled. Remaining will be 3 minus 1, 3 minus 5. Okay, so 3 minus 1 and 3 minus 5. So since it has 0, if we multiply any number with 0, it will be 0 itself. So 0 plus 0. Here also 0 and this also 0. Both will cancel. Remaining here, minus into minus is plus 1. Into determinant will be 1, 3 minus 1, 3 and minus 5. Okay, now we have to find out the determinant. 0, 0 gets cancels. Okay, 1. Next, the determinant is by multiplying the diagonal element and to subtract it. So, 3 into minus 5. 3 into minus 5 minus 3 into minus 1. Okay, so 1 into 3 into minus 5 is minus 15. Minus into minus is plus 3. 3 into 1 is 3. Okay, so here 1 into minus 15 plus 3 is minus 12, and minus 12 into 1 will be minus 12 itself. So A determinant is minus 12. So I hope you understood this, how to do the problem. So let us move on to the second question. So the second question is, let us take A itself. So that is 3, minus 4, 5. 1, 1, minus 2, and 2, 3, and 1. So let me check the question once again, because even if one number is incorrect while writing, means the whole answer will get wrong. Okay. So while writing, you have to be extra careful. So 3, minus 4, 5, 1, 1, minus 2, 2, 3, and 1. So we have to take the determinant. Here maximum number of zeros are not there. So you can take any row or any column. So, I will be taking the first row itself. Okay. So, first is 3. So, when I take 3, this column and this row will get cancels. The remaining will be 1, minus 2, 3 and 1. Okay. Next, I will be taking minus 4. Here, this is the middle term. So, the ending term, this will be the middle term. So, before writing, I have to write one more minus here. So, minus into minus 4. So, if I take minus 4, then this column and this row get cancels. This will be the edge terms we have to write. So, 1, minus 2 and 2, 1. Okay. Next is last, 5. Plus 5. So when I take plus 5, this row and this column get cancels, remaining is 1, 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So next we have to find out the product of diagonal elements with the subtraction. Okay. 1 into 1 is 1, minus 3 into minus 2 is minus 6. Okay. We have to subtract the product element. 1 1s are 1, minus 3 into minus 2 is minus 6. Next, minus into minus plus 4. So here 1 into 1, 1, minus of 2 into minus 2 is minus 4. Okay. Next, plus 5. 1 3s are 3, minus 2 1s are 2. Okay. So here 3 into 1 into minus is plus 6, plus 4. 1 into minus is plus 4, plus 5. 3 minus 2 is 1. Okay. So 3 into 6 plus 1 is 7. Plus 4, 4 plus 1 is 5, plus 5 into 1. So 3 7s are 21, plus 4 5s are 20, plus 5 1s are 5. So here it will be 46. So here the determinant A value is 46. Okay, I hope you understood this. Moving on to the third sub question of the fifth question. So here we have to find out the determinant of it. So here every column has one zero. Okay. So we can take any column here or row. I will be taking the first one itself. Okay. The first is zero. So when I take zero, so this row and this column will cancels. So remaining will be zero minus three, three, zero. So when we are taking this middle term, we have to put a minus here. So when we put minus here and when I am taking one, so this column and this row get cancels. The remaining will be minus 1, minus 3, minus 2 and 0. Okay. So when I am taking this, this column and this row get cancels. Remaining minus 1, minus 3, minus 2, 0. Okay. Next, the last one. When I am taking the last one. Okay. When I took the last one, this column and this row will get cancels. Okay. If this get cancels, remaining will be minus 1, 0, minus 2 and 3. Okay, so here 0 with anything will be 0. So put a 0 here. Next is minus 1. Next we have to multiply the product of diagonal elements. Okay, that is minus 1 into 0 is 0, minus minus 3 into minus 2. Minus 3 into minus 2, minus minus cancels. 3 2s are 6. Okay, next plus 2. Minus 1 into 3 is minus 3. Minus 2 into 0 is always 0. Okay, next 0 will cancels. Minus 1 into 0 minus 6 is minus 6 itself, plus 2 into minus 3. Okay, so here minus minus cancels. 6 1s are 6. Here plus into minus minus, 2 3s are 6. So 6 minus 6 is 0. Here the A determinant will become 0. Okay, so moving on to the next sum. Here also we can take any row or any column. I will be taking the first column here because it has a 0. Instead of taking this, you can take this. Okay. So here first 2 I will be taking. So when I take 2 here, so this column and this row get cancels. Remaining will be 2 minus 1 minus 5, 0. Okay. When I delete this row and this column, so this will be the remaining elements. 2 minus 1 minus 5, 0. Next is 0. So I will be taking the middle term. So put minus 0 here. So when I take minus 0, so this row and this column get cancels. Remaining will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 5 and 0. Okay. Next, the last element, that is plus 3. So when I take plus 3, this row and column get cancels. Minus 1, minus 2, 2 and minus 1. Okay. So 2 into 0 is 0. Minus into minus, it cancels. Here one more minus is there. So 5 will be remaining. Okay. First we have to take the product of the element. So 2 into 0. Next we have to take the subtraction. Okay. So 2 into 0 is 0. Minus. Minus 5 into minus 1 is 5 itself. Because minus minus get cancels. Okay. Next here. 0 into anything is 0. Just put a 0 here. Plus 3 into minus 1 into minus 1. Minus minus get cancels. Remaining will be 1. Minus 2 into minus 2. Okay. So 2 into minus 2, I'll be writing it directly. 2 into minus 2 is minus 4. Okay. So 2 into 0 into minus 5 is minus 5. Minus 0 cancels. Plus 3 into 1 minus into minus is plus. So 1 plus 4. So 2 into minus 5. 5 2s are 10. So it will be minus 10 plus 3 into 4 plus 1 is 5. Okay, minus 10 plus 3 5s are 15. 15 minus 10 is 5. So here the A determinant will be 5. Okay, I hope you understood this problem. Please practice it well. Only by practicing you will get easily and correctly. Okay, moving on to the sixth question. Here a matrix A is given, just we need to find out the determinant of it. Okay, so determinant of A, we have to find it out. So 1 1 minus 2, 2 1 minus 3, and 5 4 minus 9. So we have to find out the determinant of it. I'll be taking the first row here. So 1 into, if I take 1, so this column and this row will get cancels. So remaining will be 1 minus 3, 4 minus 9. Okay. Next, the middle term. When I am taking a middle term, we have to insert a minus here. So minus 1 into, if this column and this row cancels, means the edge term will be 2 minus 3, 5 minus 9. Okay. So next is minus 2. So when I take minus 2, this row and column will cancels. So this will be the remaining term. So 2, 1, 5 and 4. Okay. So next, what we have to do? We need to multiply that diagonal element with the subtraction. Okay. So 1 into minus 9. So 1 into minus 9 minus 4 into minus 3. Okay. 1 into minus 9 minus 4 into minus 3. Next, minus 1 into 2 into minus 9 minus 5 into minus 3. So 2 into minus 9 minus 5 into minus 3. Next is minus 2 into 2 into 4 minus 5 into 1. Okay. So here 1 into minus 9 is minus 9. Minus into minus plus 4 3 is 12. Here minus 1 into 2 into minus 9 is minus 18. Minus minus plus 5 3 is 15. Next, 2 4s are 8 minus 5. So 1 into, so 12 minus 9 is 3 minus 1. So minus 18 plus 15 is again 3. So it will be minus 3, because a larger number is 18. Minus 2 into 8 minus 5 is also 3. Okay. So remaining is 1 into 3, 3. Here minus minus is plus, 3 1s are 3, minus 2 3s are 6. Okay. So 3 plus 3 is 6 minus 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. So here the determinant A value is 0. I hope you understood this. So moving on to the seventh question. Here we have to find out the value of x by same determinant form. So we have to take the determinant of both sides and we have to equate it into an equation so that we have to find out the value of x here. Okay. So in the first one, I'll be taking the multiplication of the diagonal element, 2 into 1 minus 5 into 4. Okay. 2 into 1 minus 5 into 4 is equal to here 2x into x minus 6 into 4. Okay. So 2 1s are 2 minus 5 4s are 20 is equal to 2x into x is 2x squared minus 6 4s are 24. So here 2 minus 20 is minus 18 is equal to 2x squared minus 24. Next I will be taking 24 this side. So minus 24 will become plus 24 when I shift minus 24 to left hand side. So 24 minus 18 is equal to 2x squared. So 24 minus 18 is 6 is equal to 2x squared. So next I will be taking 2 this side, will become divided by into x squared. So 2 1s are 2 3s are. So it will become 3 is equal to x squared. So x is equal to plus or minus square root of 3. So here the value of x is plus or minus square root of 3. Okay. So in the same way we have to do the second problem. We have to find out the product of the diagonal element with the subtraction and we have to equate it into an equation to find out the value of x. Okay. So here 2 into 5. So 2 into 5 minus 4 into 3. 2 into 5 minus 4 into 3 is equal to here x into 5 minus 2x into 3. So 2 5s are 10 minus 4 3s are 12 is equal to x into 5 is 5x minus 2 3 is a 6 or 6x. So 10 minus 12 is minus 2 is equal to 5x minus 6x is minus 6. Here minus minus cancels. Therefore x is equal to 2. Okay, I hope you understood this. So moving on to question 8 and the last question of this session. In exercise 4.1, there are a total of 8 questions. So here it is again the same as that of the previous problem, but it is a multiple choice question. After solving, we have to find out which is the correct answer among all these 4 alternatives. Okay. So here, product of the diagonal term, that is x into x minus 18 into 2 is equal to 6 into 6 minus 18 into 2. Okay. X into x is x square minus 18 2s are 36 is equal to 6 into 6 is 36. 6 6 are 36 minus 18 2s are again 36. Okay. So 36 and 36 is 36 minus 36 is 0. So x square minus 36 is equal to 36 is minus 36 is 0. So x square, in the next I will be shifting this minus 36 this side. It will become plus 36. So x is equal to, so here in algebra what happens is when we take the square to either side, the other side if we take it, it will become plus or minus square root of. Not only just square root of, it will become plus or minus square root of. Okay. So I will be shifting this square to right hand side, it will become plus or minus square root of 36. Okay. So what is the square root of 36? Square root of 36 is 6. Plus or minus 6. So plus or minus 6 is the second option. So we have to write answer is option B. Okay. Answer is option B, that is plus or minus 6. I hope you understood this. This was the last question. If you have any queries, doubts or suggestions, anything, please comment me on the comment section below. Thanks for watching my videos.